So we're heading out to Denbigh. Heading out to go out.
I'm not going to Denbigh.
Where are you heading now?
I'm heading to
work. Heading out. Alright.
Also, so you're not coming today?
No.
Oh my.
I just been alone.
My God! You're plugging!
Get ahead, jump in, and be on our way. So we are heading to Denbigh 2022 in Clarendon, the Denbigh showground, traveling with Chris, Jaden, and Crystal. So I decided to do a little vlog. So join us, you know, let's see how the day goes. Yeah. Hoping to have a fun day. So we took the highway and went through both tolls. Boy, the toll them increase. $800 if we go through the first toll. $190 if we go through the second toll. But we arrived safely, thank God, and police were there to tell us where to go to the VIP area, the VIP gate. I think it was gate 4. So we arrived safely and we got to our destination. So let's go inside and see what's going on. So as soon as we parked and got out of the car, we walked to this place where they had a lot of goats. This goat was big. Like, I'm sure the camera isn't depicting how big this goat really is. Standing up beside him, he was peeing there, but it was amazing to see this, you know, goat that was so huge. And there were some others as well as we walked down the track to the other area. So these goats were on display. They had a competition. We kind of arrived late, so I'm not sure what the competition was about, but this goat won. It was very tall, and you know, you could see that he was well bred, and it was amazing just to see how these animals were so big. So that's how we started the day at Denbigh and moved on to the areas where there were other animals like the cows and so on. So here we have the goat and sheep area. There were a lot of goats and sheep in this area, and I touched a few of them. You know, first time even getting so close to a sheep. The head is kind of different from the goat, just observing them. And it was just fun to touch and feel the wool and so on. So here we have the cows. Went right to the cow area. And being so close to a cow, it was my first time. So I was pretty psyched. And some of these cows were very big to me. I'm sure to others, maybe they have seen bigger cows. But, you know, these animals were just peaceful. And I think they are used to humans. So they were just sitting around. Some of them were eating. And it was good to see how well taken care of they were. And they were really nice and big. And I kind of touched this one and he used his tail to fan me off. So I'm sure he didn't want to be touched, but they are very peaceful animals, very nice. And I think I want to be around them a lot more often, maybe in the future. So. Let's see how that goes. Crystal decided that she wanted to touch this cow. I wanted to touch him too. It was a big black cow. I was kind of fearful that he would have kicked up a little bit. So I was holding Jaden at this point. And Crystal went to touch the cow. And then took the camera from me. And I was going to touch the cow now. So I was asking him if I could touch the cow. And, you know, his skin was really soft. Felt kind of leathery and smooth. It's what you would expect.
For real.
JJ. JJ. Give us a real smile. JJ. Good boy. Good boy.
Yeah, we're at Denbigh Showground and we really saw a lot of well-bred animals. We saw some goats.
Yes.
Some big ram goat and some huge cows. We took some videos of them. And boy, really mind-blowing how big these animals can get. So, we're going to walk around and see what we see. What we see. We're going to walk around and see if we can look for some crops or something like that. Christopher, prepare for go on stage for the gospel segment. But the animals definitely, trust me, they really look good. They really look good.
What are you?
So we got to the place, well, I got to the place where there were a lot of plants and a lot of these really great looking small plants and cactus. Don't know if it's cacti. But I really liked these smaller plants in the pots. I walked around, it was a huge area with a lot of plants and flowers and fruit trees. Some fruit trees were small, being sold in pots as well. And I eventually bought a small cactus for $600, really nice. Asked how to take care of it and everything. And I'll show you that video as well when I was purchasing it. But for now, just enjoy looking at these plants.
Coming back here in 2022 is, you know, refreshing. I saw some really nice plants as well, so, you know, let's see what happens. I had dinner before I came, so I won't be going to grab any jerk chicken right now, maybe later on. But the gospel segment may start shortly, so I'll take some videos of those. And, you know, let's see what happens next.
My former co-worker Nilsha Pennant. So, hi Nilsha.
So, I buy that one here.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Alright, so I buy a cactus. 600. Not too much water, you say?
Yeah, not plenty water.
Right. Shaded area.
Can I get sun in on that? Yeah, man, let me pay for it.
Panadol is made from?
You can smell like weed.
Smell like ganja. Water 3 days a week. Keep it in a shady area. You can chew the leaves or
make a tea.
Make tea from it.
Or make a smoothie with pineapple.
And ginger, right?
See the Panadol plant here. I saw it.
How about this one more?
Hello, sir.
The bougie sign, man, never.
No, sir, that looks so familiar.
Cheese, hombre.
Yeah, so this is.
web, maybe they're fun.
Yeah, I'm trying to send internet to stone. Alright, so I guess these two are offline. More Wi-Fi is done over there. Alright, this is the next, setup. For this, so like you can see the amount of light that plants are receiving. And you can also turn on and off grow lights. You can set set thresholds so that
the response time crazy.
It'd be better if the Wi-Fi was faster, but so if you plant, for example, you want to keep production when there's no sunlight. What do you
mean? I'm mentioning all the perennial
charges. Yeah, my name on.
Oh, Jaden, count the 3-4 time again.
Here you go.